In this session, we are going to study the mechanism of hormone action. So, mechanism of hormone action. So, in previous sessions, we already studied what are hormones, how they are produced, and what are the different types of hormones, etc. Now, basically, we can identify two types of hormones. The hormones which are made up of protein. So they are called protein hormones or peptide hormones, and the other kind of hormones are steroid hormones, which are made up of lipid molecule. So the mechanism of hormone action differs for these two types of hormones. So for peptide hormone, the mechanism of action is different, and for steroid hormones, it is different. Now this is a diagram just to show you how steroid hormone works. So anyway, in the later session, we are going to study it in detail. Now, the hormones are the chemical messengers, and they are released directly into the bloodstream. So every hormone has a target organ. So it will go and it will stimulate or it will start the chain of biochemical reactions in the target cells or target organs or target tissues. Now, the target tissue or the cell of the target tissue, it must have receptors specific for that hormone. For example, thyroid stimulating hormone is produced by the pituitary. And the target organ for TSH hormone are thyroid gland cells. So, thyroid gland cells must have receptors for thyroxine molecules, I mean thyroxine hormones. Now, the target cell has receptors which are specific to a given hormone, and they will be activated either by a lipid soluble or water soluble hormone. As I already told you, so a protein hormone or a lipid hormone, they have different way of working or interacting with the receptors. Now, water soluble hormone, a lipophobic hormone that binds to a receptor on or within the plasma membrane, and it initiates the intracellular signaling cascade. Now, here we are talking about the protein hormone, which will bind to the receptors which are present on the surface of the cell on the plasma membrane. And what is the hormone? Hormone is a molecule which is released by a gland in one part of the body. And as I already told you, it is a chemical messenger, so it will travel to the target organ, and it will reach the target cell to do its function. So, lipid soluble hormone is a lipophilic hormone that passes through the plasma membrane of a cell. It binds to an intracellular receptor and changes the gene expression. So, in two of the previous sessions, we studied in very detail the difference between the receptors which are present on the plasma membrane, which are commonly called surface receptors, and the receptors which are present in the cytoplasm, so intracellular receptors. So protein hormones have surface receptors, whereas lipid hormones, they have intracellular receptors. Now, so here it is a diagram just to show you how a surface receptor will interact with hormone molecule and initiate the functions. Anyway, in next session we are going to study it in detail. Here, just to show you, the hormone molecule. Here, this is the hormone molecule, and this is the receptor. You can see the receptor molecule extending across the plasma membrane of the cell. So once the hormone molecule binds with the receptor, it will cause some changes. It will initiate some changes and the cascade of changes. So it will ultimately result in the production of some molecules like enzymes, hormones, whatever it is. So they are the products of this target cell. So this is how cascade of signaling reactions will lead to the action of hormone. Now, lipid soluble hormones diffuse through the plasma membrane to enter the target cell and bind to a receptor protein which is present inside the cell. Whereas water soluble hormones, they have receptors on the surface and hormone will bind to the surface receptors. Now, receptor stimulation results in a change in cell activity which may send feedback to the original hormone producing cell. So every hormone production is normally controlled by a feedback mechanism, either a positive feedback or negative feedback. So once it reaches the target organ and it will initiate some process in the target cell, so the target cell will send signal back to the gland which is producing the hormone. Say for example, insulin is the hormone and it is produced in response to the increased blood sugar level. So insulin starts getting produced in the beta cells of the pancreas, and insulin has many target cells. Say it will go to the liver cell and it will start converting insulin into it will start converting glucose into glycogen. So once there is a reduced amount of glucose in the blood, so there will be a feedback to the pancreas to stop or to reduce the production of insulin. So this is how hormones are regulated by feedback mechanism. Now, steps of hormone signaling. We see it is a general topic. Here we are discussing about the general things. Biosynthesis of particular hormone in a particular tissue, it happens in a particular tissue. It is stored and secreted by that particular gland, and transportation always takes place through the blood and it reaches the tissues or organ cells. And recognition of the hormone is done by the receptors. Either they are present on the cell surface or inside the cytoplasm. And once the receptors bind to the hormone molecule, there is a relay and amplification of the signal. So what is the signal? Arrival of the hormone molecule itself is the signal. So this signal is relayed and amplified. So then there will be a feedback mechanism for the organ or tissue which produces the hormone. So in this session, we generally discussed how the hormones function. So just to conclude, to summarize what we studied in this session, hormones are chemical messengers. Hormones are produced by the endocrine glands of the body. There are two types of hormones, peptide hormones and lipid hormones. Steroid hormones. Every hormone has the target cells, target organs. The target organs have receptors, specific receptors for a specific hormone. So the receptors for peptide hormones are present on the surface of the plasma membrane. Whereas the receptors for steroid hormones are present inside the cytoplasm. So once the hormone molecule comes and binds with the receptor molecule, that is considered as the signaling, and that signaling is relayed and amplified, and that will lead to some cascading chemical reactions, biochemical reactions inside the target cell. So that biochemical reactions are nothing but the functions intended by the hormone molecule. And so this is how the hormone action is achieved. And another important thing associated with this is the feedback mechanism. So because the hormone production, the quantity and production and stopping of the hormone production must be controlled, and that is controlled by the feedback mechanism. So this is about the hormone action we studied in this session. Thank you.